My name is Habon Issa, and we're at the George Washington University. I'm currently working on diseases such as muscular dystrophy and disorders of glycosylation, and there are really devastating effects. I'm actually from nearby in Virginia, and I actually didn't know too much about research. And when I came to George Washington to study medicine, I stumbled upon this research opportunity, and I was really lucky to end up in this lab to get to kind of learn about the everyday, day-to-day lab work that I never had exposure to, and I really started to like it. A lot of people not only care about your input, but they really depend on it, and there's a common misconception that you kind of sit and do the same thing every day, but it changes every single day. You're learning, and as soon as you learn, you're already doing everything. It's very hands-on, and I enjoyed it a lot. I had an uncle as well as a cousin that were affected by a type of muscular dystrophy. A lot of the phenotypes are very severe very early on. A lot of the children lose control or tone of their muscles, so they can't do everyday things as easily, such as walking and learning as easily as other children are able to. The lifespan varies, but usually they die at about mid-infancy. Some can survive longer, but around 5 years at the latest are a lot of the children's lifespans. Usually when I come into the lab, I do pipetting of things such as PCR techniques, and I look at some of the slides and prepare samples to analyze some of the disorders that I'm working on. We look at the microscopes to visualize our samples and to stain some of our samples. A lot of the work is microscopic. Right now we're just looking at zebrafish sections from the head all the way back to the tail. I work with some of the postdocs, and we often go over a lot of the protocols together and do similar projects, my own individual projects. We do a lot of reading of articles because a lot of the techniques that we're trying to use are very unheard of, and we're trying to learn more about what other people are doing to see if we can try and use some of these techniques to further our own project. I think it's very rewarding not only to learn about these disorders that are very rare and often undiagnosed. I think it's nice to kind of see your work develop right in front of your eyes very quickly. In the short term, it would be nice to understand the basic mechanisms and the way that this disease operates, and perhaps help to create therapeutic approaches to combat the disease as well. You try research, whether or not you're directly interested in research or medicine. I think it's a very fulfilling experience that you can only really learn about when you're actually doing the work.